Hey guys, welcome back to another video. My name is Shivaan and I'm a second year medical student studying at King's College London. So basically, in today's video, I'm going to talk to you about whether it's better to do an MBBS in the UK or whether it's better to do one in India. So we're going to compare the two countries to study medicine. But before we get further into the video, I want you to go check out my YouTube channel, because I make YouTube videos about medical school and university. And basically I have vlogs, day in the life videos, get into medical school videos. So check all of them out. If you like them, if you enjoy them, do subscribe to my channel and follow me for a lot more videos. Anyway, back to this video. So today, like I said, we're going to be talking about medical school in the UK versus medical school in India. So let's start by talking about a few very central points comparing the two. So things like fees, salary, curriculum, those are the main ones, obviously. So let's start off by talking about fees. So medical school in the UK, first of all, that costs somewhere between £33,000 to £41,000 a year. That's subject to inflation. In future years, that will probably increase. So that's 33 to 41 lakhs a year. Oxford and Cambridge are slightly more expensive because they charge a lot more for their clinical years and a little less for their preclinical years. So you'd want to check that out on their website. But the 33,000 to 41,000 that I gave you, that's pretty much the figure that covers all other medical schools. So we have 33 to 41 lakh rupees here. Now let's talk about Indian medical schools. So Indian medical schools, they are very varied, because you could be studying at a government medical school, a private medical school, and within each one there's a massive range as well. So government medical schools, they can be very cost effective. They can be £50 a year, literally 5,000 rupees a year, or they could be much more expensive. But in the maximum you will see probably, and I'm not 100% sure on this because I'm not an expert, but this is from my research, the maximum you'll see annually at a government medical school is around 1 lakh rupees a year. That's £1,000 for the sake of comparison. So like you can see, government medical schools in India are very cost effective, not expensive at all. And then if you're looking at private medical schools in India, you could be looking at anywhere between 5 lakhs a year or 50,000, £5,000 a year, slightly above 20 lakhs a year or 20 lakh rupees a year. That's £20,000 a year. And it could even be more expensive with mandatory donations, capitation fees, etc. I don't know how much of that still goes on, but it can end up being quite expensive studying in a medical school in India. Comparing the two, India is generally much cheaper to study in. However, some private medical institutions could be almost as expensive as studying in the UK. Now, let's talk about salary. So salary is the next point, obviously. And this is the salary you earn after you graduate from medical school. So as a junior doctor in the UK,
Now I say junior doctor in the next clip, but I mean a specialist training doctor. The statistic for a junior doctor is up here right now. So that's the statistic for a junior doctor.
You will be earning between £36,000 and £53,000 a year. That's 36 lakhs to 53 lakhs a year. As a consultant, you'll be earning between £84,000 to £114,000 a year. That's 84 lakhs to 1 crore, 15,000 rupees.
1 crore, 15 lakh rupees, my bad.
And that's the... all these figures have been taken from the NHS Health Careers website. In India, this amount is much more varied. So basically, in India, you could be looking for a salary that is anywhere from £3,600 or 3.6 lakhs a year to 6 crore rupees or £600,000 a year. So there's a much wider spectrum here. The spectrum can be widened a little bit in the UK if you work privately, because you can earn a bit more. But yeah, that's generally the comparison. So what the takeaway from that is, in India, there's a much bigger risk, and it really depends on where you work, whether you work at a public institution or a private institution, what your reputation is, what your specialization is, your seniority. Many factors can affect how much you earn. Versus in the UK, it's much more regularized, and there's a much more standard amount that you're earning as a doctor. And last essential point is your curriculums. So the curriculum is actually quite similar in both countries. In the UK and in India, it's around 5 years, can be 6 in the UK if you're starting at Imperial, UCL, Edinburgh, Oxford, Cambridge, because they have a mandated year of intercalation, or if you choose to intercalate, which is basically a specialized year of study and something. But yeah, it's generally 5 years in both places. You have to see that the curriculum in the UK can be much more varied than that in India. In India, it's generally one preclinical year, 3 years of clinical placement and studies in medical school, and a fifth year after that of just clinical placement. It's called an internship year, and you are basically just working in the hospital. In the UK, you can face many different curriculums. An integrated curriculum, which is basically system-based teaching, and it's clinical placement along with obviously normal studies in medical school. And then you have problem-based learning, which is case-based learning. You take a problem, you learn everything around that, and that's how you sort of move forward in the curriculum. And then finally, you have the traditional curriculum, which is 3 preclinical years or few preclinical years, and then 3 years of clinical study. So that's the difference between the two. One thing I will say is, in the UK, you do have a much more holistic degree, because they teach you a lot about human factors and soft skills here, about patient interaction, about how to sort of lead a consultation, how to study psychosocial factors that affect medicine, studying philosophy, economics of medicine, research, things like that. So the degree is slightly more holistic. Yeah, so that was all your primary sort of concerns. Now let's talk about some secondary sort of topics or factors here. So first, we have global recognition, reputation, ranking, stuff like that of your institution. I know I don't like to talk about rankings, and I'm very sort of iffy on saying how much they matter, but if this is something that matters to you, if the reputation of your university is something that matters to you, you have an advantage in the UK. Because in the top 100 medical schools in the world, ranked by QS, there are 14 medical schools from the UK, and there are 0 medical schools from India. The first Indian medical school in the rankings is AIIMS, and its ranking is 151 to 200. But yeah, so if you're looking at reputation, ranking of your institution, you have an advantage in the UK. The next point is research. Research is a massive part of medicine nowadays, and just like with rankings, you have an advantage here in the UK. So the UK is the second biggest contributor to life sciences and research in medicine in the world after the US. So there's groundbreaking research happening here, very significant research. So you are really impacted by that as a medical student, because you're studying at the universities where this research is taking place, you're seeing it happen, and you learn about it, and you really get all of the benefits that really come with that research happening around you. Then you get more research on an individual basis as well. It's woven into your curriculum, and there are many more opportunities for it otherwise as well, which gives you a slight sort of advantage over research in India. Now let's talk about some random points in favor of both or against both. So India, as you would know, second most populated country in the world, 1.3 billion people. Hygiene and sanitation and such problems are being tackled there right now. So obviously you have a lot of people, and on top of that, you have a lot of sick people. So you get a lot more patient exposure. You see so many patients over there working in medical school. You get such a high caseload at your hospitals that you learn a lot. And that's sort of an advantage for medical school in India. However, medical school in the UK means you're working in the NHS, a pretty good healthcare system to be working in. And it's sort of been tailored over the past few years to work well for the UK. It has its flaws, as every healthcare system does, but overall it's working pretty well and it's not a bad place to be working as a doctor. Employment rate in the NHS also is 99.3%, so if you're a doctor, there's a very high likelihood that you'll be employed by the NHS. On top of that, studying in the UK, if you're an Indian student, it might lend for an opportunity for personality development. Obviously, you're studying in abroad, you're going there all by yourself. You learn to be independent, you learn many important life skills. You'll meet people from many different countries and you'll experience different cultures, a different culture, and that's something that'll benefit you a lot. The UK also has better infrastructure than India, as medical schools are so world-renowned and obviously have a lot of financial backing, and therefore teaching facilities, medical facilities, research facilities, all of them are literally as good as they can be in the UK. The UK has a higher standard of living than India. It's ranked 13th on the Human Development Index, which is a measure of standard of living, with a score of 0.932. And India is 131st on this list, with a score of 0.645. So higher standard of living in the UK, but that comes along with a higher cost of living as well. So on the cost of living index, it's ranked 24th in the UK, 24th most expensive. And after that, India comes in at 134th. So it's quite low. So you're facing a slightly low cost of living in India. That is pretty much the advantages and disadvantages of both, I'd say. I don't think I can think of any more relevant points. Have any other things that you want to know about, do leave a comment down below. Ask me any questions you'd like and about this, and we can have a little discussion. At the end of the day, I'm a medical student too who made this decision, and I'll share my thought process with you a bit. And yeah, I hope you found this video useful. I hope you liked it. Hope you found it interesting. If you did, drop a like down below, hit that subscribe button, and share the video with other people who may find it useful. And I will see you in the next one.